This is your fourth practical. The object is to find the reduction factor of tangent galvanometer. The apparatus used for this experiment is tangent galvanometer, ammeter, four-way key, rheostat, and a power supply of 2 to 3 volts. The formula used for finding reduction factor K is equal to I upon tan theta, where I is the current shown by the ammeter and theta is the angle which the needle makes with the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Tangent galvanometer works on the principle of tangent law, which states that when a magnet is acted upon by two right angled magnetic fields in such a way that the magnetic needle makes an angle theta with the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field, then in the equilibrium position, the ratio of these two magnetic fields is equal to tan of the angle made by the magnetic needle with the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. Suppose we are having B is the magnetic field due to the coil and BH is the magnetic field, horizontal component of magnetic field of Earth, then according to tangent law, in equilibrium position, B upon BH is equal to tan theta. Here BH is indicating the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. So tangent galvanometer works on this principle. Now, starting the experiment, this is your circuit diagram where you can see the positive terminal of the DC supply is connected to one end of ammeter, second end to the four-way keys diagonal portion, one and second end of the diagonal point of four-way key is connected to rheostat, and remaining two points are connected with the tangent galvanometer. So this is your forward wise. In reverse wise, we just change the direction of the current, then the magnetic needle of the TG will move in other direction. So this is your circuit diagram for the experiment which you are seeing on board. Now coming to the apparatus, in figure you are seeing this is your power supply, this is your rheostat, this is four-way key, this is ammeter, and this is tangent galvanometer. Before starting experiment, we need to set our tangent galvanometer. The tangent galvanometer is consisting of this scale which is divided into four quadrants. You can see 0 to 90, then again 90, and it is all 360 degree marked. Here is a position of the needle before starting must be at 0, 0, and this needle should be parallel to the vertical magnetic field due to the coils. We are having number of coils which can be 5, 50 or 500 as per our choice. When we say the number of turns of the coil are 5, it means the magnetic field is produced by the 5 turns, and when we connect it at 50 point, it means the magnetic field is produced by 50 turns of the coil, and so on. Similarly, if you connect the coil between 0 to 500, then the magnetic field produced will be of 500 turns. So here we are taking reading at 50, n is equal to 50. So magnetic field produced by 50 turns. This TG is having this 3 leveling screws so that your pivot should be stable and needle can move freely. So by adjusting these screws, you can make the pivot to move freely. This is your tangent galvanometer. This is your ammeter. Similarly, ammeter is used to find the current, value of current. So we will find the least count of this ammeter, the number of divisions, main scale division between 0 and 0.2, the small scale divisions are 10, so least count of ammeter is 0.2 by 10, that is 0.02. And now coming to the connection part, this is your power supply. The positive end of the power supply is connected to ammeter's positive end, here same thing, and negative end of the ammeter is connected to the one end of the four-way key. You should take care, we will take diagonal points. Either you can take these two diagonal points or these two diagonal points. So one end of the ammeter is connected to this diagonal point of the four-way key, and second end of this four-way key diagonally is connected to the rheostat. This is one end, and second variable end is connected to the negative of the battery. And this TG is connected between the remaining two diagonal points of four-way key. Clear? Once again, I am repeating, we will start from this power supply. The positive end of the power supply is connected to the positive end of the ammeter. Negative end of the ammeter is connected to one of the diagonal point of this four-way key, and second point diagonally is connected to the rheostat's one end, and variable point is connected to the negative of the battery. And TG here, 0 to 50 turns terminals, they are connected with the remaining two diagonal points of the four-way key or reversing key. So this is your circuit diagram. Okay, now we are going to start the experiment. Our conditions are fulfilled, TG is well set, and other corrections are okay. So we are going to start the experiment. So I put on the power here, and I connected these two keys diagonally with the four-way key. So when I did this, there is a reading in this TG. You can see it is the one side of needle is moving this side, and second end of the needle is moving this side. So it will acquire a stable position within 10 to 15 seconds. Then note down the position of the needle. Initially it was at 0, 0. Now it is showing the reading nearly 60 degree. Okay, so in forward bias you are saying theta 1 is 60, theta 2 is also 60. Now reversing the connection, I just current corresponding here is, it is total number of divisions is 6 into 0.02, it will be 0.12. So current in ampere I is 0.12, and theta 1 theta 2 by Tg are 60 degree. Now reversing the connections here, initially we connected the keys like this, now we are connecting the keys like this in opposite direction. Okay, again needle will move. Now this end will move toward this side, and this end of needle will move towards other side. It will be also acquiring a stable position after 10 to 15 seconds. So we will note it down. So it is coming nicely back to nearly degree. Okay, so theta 3 is 62 degree and theta 4 is also 62 degree. Now the mean of these theta 1, theta 2, theta, theta 4 will be equal to 61. So mean tan theta value tan 61 is equal to 1.8, and the value of reduction factor k, which is equal to I upon tan theta, is equal to 0.0067 ampere for 50 turns, because we are using magnetic field of 50 turns. So this is your first reading. For second reading, we will change the current from here. Then again we will note the reading. So just putting it off here and changing current conditions from here. Again repeating the experiment in the same way, in forward wise and reverse wise. In forward wise, the value of current is nearly 0.13 as shown by the ammeter, and the theta 1 and theta 2 value are 63 degree. And again reversing these keys, the value of theta 3 and theta 4 will come out to be nearly 61. So the mean value of theta is 62 and tan theta is equal to 1.88. So doing the calculation on the similar lines, k will come out to be I upon tan theta, which is equal to 0.069. So mean value of the reduction factor k will be equal to 0.068. So in this way you can repeat the experiment with 500 turns also, with 5 turns also, and you will be able to see that k varies with the number of turns when n increases. So there is a formula which you are seeing on the board, that k, reduction factor k, is equal to I upon tan theta, or 2 BHR upon mu naught n is equal to k. So k will be more if n will be small, and k will be large if n is, k will be large if n will be small, and k will be small if n is large, inversely proportional to number of turns. As you can see, k is equal to 2 BHR upon mu naught n. So the value of k will depend upon the number of turns. If number of turns increases, the value of k decreases. If number of n increases, the value of k decreases, inversely proportional to number of turns. If n increases, k decreases. If n decreases, k increases. So you can do the experiment by changing number of turns, or by changing the value of current flowing through the TG. In this way you can find the reduction factor of tangent galvanometer. Okay, so this was your experiment to find the reduction factor of tangent galvanometer. The main precautions to be taken in this experiment is there should not be any magnetic material near the magnet. While performing experiment, you should not wear any watch which is having magnetic chain or any other thing which is magnetic should not be near the TG. It can affect the magnetic needle. Second, the pivot should be free to move. The needle should move freely. There should be no friction while moving in the needle. And note down the theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4 very carefully. Before starting the experiment, the needle must be showing 0-0 position and the magnet should be parallel to the vertical field which you are externally applying of 5 turns or 50 turns or 500 turns. The needle should be set in the magnetic meridian. Okay, so this was your fourth experiment which we today performed in the lab for you people. So please note it down. Again, observe the experiment carefully. So this is all for this experiment. Okay, thank you.